Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass Workshop series, where we built a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrated Wired Wireless Active Directory and much more. So in a previous video, we enabled MAC enforcement based on profiling information. In this video, we will have two more advanced scenarios. So first will be a PC behind a phone, behind the IP phone, and the second will be InstantAP with tagged VLANs on an authenticated port. So first, let's make it a bit easier to see. And in our access tracker, we can go to the edit button and we can, under the available columns, we can select the NAS port, which is the switch port number. And if we select that, we can now see the port for each of the authentications. So we can see the .1x authentication on port 3, the VoIP phone on 7, and the IP camera on port 11. So that's easier to see what we are doing at this point. So you can easily add columns to the access tracker and remove them as well if you don't need them. So what we will do is we will move the contractor now connected on port 3 behind the phone on port 7. And in order to do that, we need to have an additional command in our interface commands. So we had the concurrent onboarding already, but we need to allow more than one device per interface. So if we check the configuration, the command to configure the client limit, so the maximum number of clients, is AAA authentication port access client limit, and you can see the default is set to one. So that means just one device can authenticate. So if you have an IP phone and a client behind it, the client behind it will not authenticate. For this demo, we'll put it to three, and I think three concurrent clients is a pretty good number. So write that configuration. So next, I will move the .1x client to the pass-through port on the VoIP phone, and then it should connect on port 7 as well. So let's have a look. And yes, that worked. So we can see two clients on port 7. One is MAC authenticated and it's the VoIP phone. And the other one is .1x authenticated, and that is our contractor, so the .1x client. So we can see we have two clients behind the same port. As well, in the access tracker, we can see two different clients, both on NAS port number 7. And we can see that we have different profiles returned. So we have the VoIP role and we have the contractor role. Now, if we check the IP addresses, so show client IP, what we can see as well that we have the same port, 7, but we have a different VLAN. So VLAN 12 for the VoIP phone, which also has an IP address in VLAN 12, and the client, the .1x client, is in VLAN 13, and it has an IP address also in port 13. Note that these clients are not using VLAN tagging. They're both in the native VLAN, but the native VLAN for one client is 12, and for the other client, it's just 13. So that was not too hard. Then our second scenario for this video, and that is our InstantAP. Till now, I had my InstantAP connected to my core switch, so we didn't see it at the access switch. But in some cases, it's useful to get access points connected to an authenticated port as well. So if people have access to the connection to the InstantAP, they can pull off the AP and then link on, and then you have access to the management VLAN as well to all of the tagged client VLANs. So for that reason, it may be good to have authentication on that port as well. In order to make that happen, we can create just another role. And in that role, we can do a few other things that we did before. So we don't have just the VLAN access, but now we can use the VLAN trunk command. And we can put the native VLAN of the management VLAN. And we can also put tagged as the named VLANs for our client access. So that's one point, but another point is that by default, as we have seen, if we have multiple devices on the same port, both devices are authenticated. But for our InstantAP, we do the authentication on the AP, so it doesn't make sense to do the authentication again on the switch. And in order to do that, we can use the auth mode, device mode command. And what that will do, let me first put in the auth mode and see what the options are. So we have the option client mode, which is the default, where we are authenticating each of the client. We have the multi-domain, and in the multi-domain, there is an authentication for the native VLAN and one for the voice VLAN. But in the device mode, what will happen is that the first device that comes on the network, which is the AP, that will authenticate, and then all other clients are just allowed through, so without any authentication. So for our InstantAP, that's what we need, off mode, device mode. So next on the ClearPass, let's do the same that we did for the other devices. So first create a ClearPass role, the AWS InstantAP, and we can assign that role in a role mapping. So we go to the device role mapping, and in our mapping rules, you can just add another rule. In this case, we check the endpoint repository. We don't take the category, but we take the device name because we just want to have a match on Aruba InstantAP, Aruba IAP. We don't want to have this role triggered for other APs because we don't control them. Let's save that. Next is we can create a profile. Let's take our VoIP profile and create a copy of that. So we can change that to the InstantAP. The returned user role, of course, is instant-ap, what we configured on the switch. And the enforcement profile needs to be added to our enforcement policy. So take the AOS-CX MAC enforcement policy. We create a new rule. If the tips role equals instant-ap, so that matches our role mapping, then we return the instant-ap enforcement profile. Now we need to move it up because it needs to be in front of the profiler default role. So that's it. I will now plug in my InstantAP, and booting up the AP will take a while. So I will skip the video for a few minutes. And we are back, and we can see the MAC authentication on port number 6 for InstantAP. And we see that we indeed have our InstantAP enforcement. So that's all good. Now let's have a look on the switch, which show port access clients. What we can see that we indeed have on port 6 our InstantAP role, and also good to see in the front of the row you can see the D for device mode. So we can see the switch to device mode worked as well. And now have a look more in detail. So show port access client interface 116 detail. Here we can see the management IP address, which is in the VLAN 10, the management VLAN. We can, if we scroll down, that we have the authentication mode as device mode. And if we further scroll down, we can see our VLAN, so the native VLAN, and our allowed trunk VLANs as well, with all of the client VLANs. And as well, if we do a show VLAN, we can see now the 116 port is assigned to all of the client VLANs as well as to the management VLAN. So from the switch point, this all looks good, but as the proof is in the eating of the pudding, we can now connect to our Airheads Corp SSID, and we are connected. And our ClearPass access tracker, we can see the .1x authentication on the wireless, so it's coming from the InstantAP, not from the switch, and we don't see any additional authentication from the switch, just the original authentication on port 6 for the InstantAP. If we check in the accounting, we can see that we have an IP address in VLAN 10, and that's because we didn't do any VLAN assignment, just role assignment for the InstantAP. And that's something that we can quickly fix just to prove that we can also assign a tagged VLAN. So we can create a new enforcement profile, the Aruba Radius enforcement. Let's call that VLAN 13, which is our guest VLAN. And instead of the Aruba user role, we will return the Aruba user VLAN with the value of 13. Now we go into our policy, and for the Aruba Instant.1x enforcement, we will change the rule for the contractor, and we assign also the VLAN 13 in addition to the contractor role. Now we can do a re-authentication for this client. Do we change status and the Aruba OS wireless terminate session because it's a wireless client. There we see the re-authentication. Now we have assigned VLAN 13 as well. And if we now go to our clients and check the IP address on the client, we can see that we are getting an IP address in VLAN 13. So that's all good. As well, in the access tracker, we saw that we didn't do any additional authentication. To really be sure, let's check if we can reach out to the internet. Let's check the Airhead site and we can access it. So all good with port mode. We can authenticate the access point, and after that, all the clients that are authenticated already on the AP, we don't need to authenticate them again on the switch. Hope this was useful. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to our channel. And if you have any questions, you can put them under the video or connect to the Airheads community. Thanks for watching.